Last month, we brought you the work of Japanese artist Yayoi Kusama and her latest exhibition, Cosmic Garden, at the New York Botanical Garden. The outdoor exhibit captured her fantastical art from the mid-1940s all the way through 2020. Last week, Kusama's work was on display again in New York, this time at an auction that fetched more than $15 million for some of her earliest and rarely seen works of art. NewsHour Weekend's Christopher Booker has more.
Long before 92-year-old Yayoi Kusama became one of the world's most celebrated artists, she was a struggling artist in New York. She arrived in the U.S. in 1957 with a suitcase full of kimonos and paintings. And just a few years later, she crossed paths with a fellow Japanese doctor who had unwittingly become a steward of her work.
Dr. Hirase was a very well-respected doctor, author of more than 40 books on the profession, and he was a philanthropist.
Rafe Taylor is the global head of post-war and contemporary art at Bonhams, one of the oldest auction houses in the world. He helped uncover the story of some of Kusama's earliest pieces. In 1960, while living in New York, Kusama sought out the care of Dr. Hirase, himself a recent immigrant and one of only two Japanese-speaking doctors in the city. Unable to pay for his services, she gave the doctor 11 pieces of her artwork. And that began a lifelong friendship.
This is kind of a unique American story. They both have arrived in New York. She is a struggling artist, and because of the nuances of our city, of the American healthcare system, this relationship is forged.
Absolutely, and that is it's a really important point. You know, she was definitely someone who was desperate to move to America, who really wanted to throw off the shackles of post-war Japanese life, and the same actually for Dr. Hirase, but in a slightly different way. So I think it's really only in America, in the wonderful melting pot in the 50s and 60s, that you could have found these two combining into this unlikely duo.
Dr. Hirase passed away in 2019. The work of his long-ago patient still hanging on his walls.
With Amelia there at $3.8 million, and we sell it here in Bonhams, New York.
And on Wednesday, art dealers from around the world bid on these rarely seen works from the earliest days of Kusama's career. 8 pieces she brought on the plane with her from Japan, and 3 paintings created after arriving in the U.S.
Where did these works fit within the story of Kusama?
The works themselves, as they fit into the artist's career, are totemic. You know, she is someone whose most familiar themes revolve around flowers, around the polka dots, around infinity nets, and then latterly things like pumpkins, etc. But really, her most important works, you think of the infinity net, and these river paintings are absolutely fundamental. So really, you know, these are at the most significant point in her career. And there are very, very few works like these.
Kusama thrust herself into her art and in the early 1960s painted Untitled and these two pieces, Hudson River and Mississippi River, one of the first times red appears in her work.
A lot of the themes in her works are represented in these, but she's doing it through the lens of New York. So the river, there was a river behind her house growing up in Japan, and it was a meditative place for her. She had not a very happy childhood, but she used to go and sit by the river and watch it flowing. And so that is an absolutely central theme in her work. But then, you know, this is the Hudson River, the Mississippi River. So this is an accumulation of these experiences, but very much rooted in America.
The 8 pieces she brought with her from Japan are rife with symbols of her upbringing as the daughter of seed merchants. They sold on Wednesday for $3 million, and her New York works fetched more than $12 million.
This whole project is a celebration of his life, of that relationship, of his keen eye and his charitable nature, but also, you know, this fantastic artist who bestrides the world these days. You know, these are the urgent but very early evocations of her talent. And I think it's only natural and appropriate that that should also manifest in price. And so it's about people who recognize Kusama as being one of the preeminent artists, hugely influential. She represents so much to so many people. But the opportunity to be able to own these works is very rare, works such as this.